Turncoats get burned oats. That's not a bad one. This week in history, the Revolutionary War, 1780. American Major General Benedict Arnold gives the plans to the fort at West Point, New York, to the British. Benedict Arnold, the hero of Ticonderoga and Saratoga, is given command of West Point because of the absolute trust George Washington has in him. Arnold, however, has been conspiring with the British for years, sending them American troop movements, sabotaging supplies, and making himself rich in the process. Allowing the British to take West Point would be his biggest payday, with British General Henry Clinton offering him £20,000. Arnold is foiled at the last moment, though, when John Andre, the British spymaster, is captured by New York militiamen while holding the plans and Arnold's letters. Benedict Arnold's decision to betray America is as confusing as it is loathsome. Some historians theorize he was frustrated with Congress for not giving him credit for his victories, or that he needed money to pay off his substantial debts. Others blame his wife, Peggy Shippen, who had loyalist sympathies and a romantic history with the British spymaster Jean Andre. In his open letter to Americans, Arnold claimed it was because he never wanted independence, only self-governance, and he was still a loyal Brit. This failed to convince the British, though. After Arnold switched sides, he is loathed and untrusted by the British public as well, and fails to find the glory and wealth he thought he deserved. Benedict Arnold doesn't seem to have British sympathies until he meets his soon-to-be wife, Peggy Shippen. Peggy Shippen is an 18-year-old daughter of a very traditional loyalist judge in Philadelphia. She had a fling for a period with that spymaster, John Andre, and she suddenly marries Benedict Arnold, and suddenly Benedict Arnold is talking to this old spymaster and talking about Congress as if it's doing the wrong thing and the British have the right idea. Modern historians tend to think that she was the one manipulating him and he was just going along with it because she was a very pretty young woman. Yes, yeah, snitches get stitches and betrayers get gout and die at the age of 60. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content, check out our website or our Facebook pages.